Justin, happy NaNoWriMo, buddy.
NaNoWriMo was last month, you dipshit.
But any month can be NaNoWriMo if you believe in the power of NaNoWriMo in your heart.
I do.
Well, then good news. We're about to NaNoWriMo the shit out of this game. It's called Elegy for a Dead World. It is...
Cheery?
What?
Cheery. It's a cheery title.
Okay. Oh, I thought you said cherry. Like...
No, like cheery.
Okay. It is...
I'm gonna puke. Stop fucking flying around.
No, I'm going to. It is the latest title from Dejoban Games, who you might know from a very thematically similar game. A Reckless
Real
Disregard
Monsters.
For Gravity. No.
No.
They are working on an All Real Monsters licensed product. They're going to have to get the rights back from THQ, though, which is going to be a problem. They're going to have to dig through the boneyard. This is a game about writing, Justin. About writing about space adventures. So,
stop. I'm going to puke.
Okay, tell me which portal you want me
that
to go in.
One.
You didn't even look at the other two. You got to compare. That one was all purple and cloudy. Looks like we got some derelict structures in this one. I know you love derelict structures. What's this? This just looks like books.
All right, fine. Go to Book World.
God, it's like you don't even care.
Book World is where they sell all the like $6 cookbooks.
Yeah, yeah. This is
the cover's a little torn, but don't let that scare you.
This is actually the Campus Christian bookstore level.
Sondervan's.
Before we hop in, do you want to read what other people have written in these worlds, or are you afraid that it might influence our grand works?
Maybe. Well, it's tough. Maybe just
let's just see what we can do with it. So before we start, we have to pick a prompt. So there's all kinds of different ones. I think that the first one, this is Byron's world. This is sort of the standard, I guess. And it's hard, I guess, to explain what these mean unless you understand what the game is. It's a game about writing. Or we can just go free form. We can just write what we want. Or we can do a grammar workshop. Do you want to learn?
No, not that.
I've been worried about your grammar lately. You've been mixing up your theirs.
I like the name This Vacation is Terrible.
Okay, we can do that. Maybe that seems a little bit more childish. I like more hard sci-fi. Okay, well, here we go. So here we are. Let's move my cursor out of the way.
Look at you. You're adorable.
I'm just doing some jetpack stunts. And here's our first little writing prompt. So we're going to pop in. Look at this place. It's so blank.
Horny.
Horny. Okay. So this is basically just going to be Mad Libs then, huh? And the sand...
is so desolate.
Is so, so desolate.
Like...
oh.
Like a dry sandwich without mayonnaise.
Is that how you... that's just... I just sort of did a phonetic...
in my head.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So there's the first one down. We just wrote a chapter in our space book.
So how do you get points?
Let's see if there's any points in this building. No, it just looks like runes. This library is...
Full of DVDs.
DVDs of Click. Starring Adam Sandler. Who is my favorite dramatic actor. I like Click because it shows off Adam's dramatic acting talents.
Copies of Click?
Of Click.
More copies of Click.
More copies of Click forever. I think this is where they print the Click DVD.
Cool planet.
All right. So we solved that puzzle. Oh, okay. Here's a pylon. Oh, Justin, the pylon is very loud.
Is it loud? Can you hear it?
It's loud. I can hear the loud pylon. The sculptures were...
they look like giant PlayStation Move controllers, but I don't think that... thanks to the inner caps. bother. This is rivet. This is riveting audio. Perfect.
Listen, this is not going to be like our other videos. It's gonna be
serene. This is a tranquil adult game.
Mm-hmm.
For adults.
The ruins were in terrible condition. Yeah, no shit.
Hardly good.
Oh man, you really crushed that one.
Stuff.
Oh man, Justin. Woof. And the Pulitzer goes to.
Inspirational posters.
Oh no, this is gonna be a bad prompt.
Shit on the floor. And then on the door. And then by the door, sorry.
Whoosh.
This is gonna get so many.
What is this? The best video on the internet?
Now, well, the extended theatrical trailer in Spanish.
I don't feel... Should we rewrite this one? I feel like it might be a little puerile, and I feel like it might... our book might be rated... I'm aiming for, like, young adult fiction, and I feel like this might be a little too...
Okay, coarse. So this first sentence is good, and they had hardly enough bathrooms.
Yeah. But then let's not...
You're going for young adult... You're going for young... Okay, how about this? I look for a bathroom... for a long time. And then I met a beautiful teenage wolfman / alien. Perfect.
And I feel like we can, now that we've started to pivot onto the
story.
Yeah.
Okay. Love? How is that possible? I'm half cat.
All right, give me something good. Oh, a room. These are usually very exciting. Whoa!
There's no
prompts.
No prompts. Well, you just supposed to look at it? What kind of game is this?
Maybe it's hidden. Maybe there's hidden Easter eggs up. Oh, nope. Oh. What?
That's not a good prompt.
No, you know what? We're going to express ourselves. We're going to go off script.
I'm writing here. On this blue wall to note that that looks like orange face. I miss the way his fur would get caught in my mouth.
Why would the fur get caught in the mouth?
Because you're kissing him. From kissing him, yes.
Whoosh. I love the jetpack. Oh, wait, maybe this one has...
Maybe this is where the actual game part is.
Nope.
Nope, no game here.
Maybe there's some rings that the game will make me fly through later.
Oh, that would be good for points. Go the other way. I bet there's a warp zone.
Whoa, Justin, you're on some next level shit. No.
No.
Ice. Okay, so we've hit 7 of the 10 writing prompts. Maybe it's time that we start putting some friction in the story.
Okay. Any doubt that our parents from space, in parenthetical,
from space
and a different time. They're from space and a different time.
Okay, so you left out a word there. So that just a quick editor's note. I'm putting a little red carrot here.
Okay.
Our parents are... Why is it in parentheses then?
Our parents who are from space.
Who... Oh, that goes within... Okay.
Yeah, there we go.
Are from space. Okay.
And a different time.
Still in the parentheticals?
Still in the parentheticals, yeah. This okay. is good writing.
Who are from space and also a different time.
Yeah. I said very, but that's fine. It's good editing.
Yeah, you don't want to belabor the point.
Yeah.
Parents who are from space and also a different time. We're not our parents. How about that?
Oh, twist.
Also not from space. No, I don't like that. It goes against everything that I love about this story so far. Who were not our parents. Were also Alf's parents.
Twist. Then put twist in parentheticals. And the tour guides pointed out the special pit that could bring dead Alfs.
Did Alf die?
No, listen, let me finish. Dead Alfs back to life.
Okay. Well, you need
and
to.
Said, foreshadowing. Dig it.
That our parents were not our parents, we're also Alf's parents. Okay, no, that's gotta go.
It's not good. It's not. I don't think that
we're
works.
We're also Alf's parents. Twist, and the tour guys pointed out that there was the special pit. Foreshadowing, dig it. Okay, good so far.
Okay,
I think this one's gonna get a lot of.
We have two phrases. We have two sections to bring this.
Right, climax. This place was so. Nope, that's on the prompt. This one's on the prompt, isn't it?
Yeah.
If this place was so.
Safe. Then why did... Get rid of they. Kill they. That's not gonna work.
Then why did what?
I was basically thinking, like, Alf would have to die. Alf has to die in this one for him to come back in the last one.
Okay, then let's just... This is just... Kill the prompt. Alf died today.
Yeah. Oh, that's good. Yeah.
Oh, check this out. I turned him into a beautiful, stoic... snowman. See, because it's got the thing right there.
I left a hole.
I could stuff in cats.
Just in case.
JIC.
I wish there was some way we could be reunited.
How's that sentence?
Leave it.
Do I too must die? Uh-oh.
There's the device. That would work perfect.
Yeah, but we don't get the prompt of the device. This is it.
Kill all that. We don't have room. We don't have room for that garbage.
Okay.
Suddenly, it occurred to me.
Does occurred have two? There's no, I don't think there's...
Three R's. Curb to me. I had left click paused in my ship's Blu-ray player. So I could just go watch that. Alfu? I don't think we're capitalizing on the Chekhov's gun I deployed.
Yeah.
Wait, how is this a 9 of 10?
This is the last one. See?
Okay. Okay, okay.
Do you feel good about this? Do you think? I feel like this might leave people hanging on the edge. And like, let's look at the demographics for the top producing fiction novels of 2014. I think we need to maybe have a little 50 Shades of Grey up in here.
Okay. All right.
Okay. There it is. That's the start of the prompt, and that's as good as it fucking gets.
Does she have Alf's corpse?
Are we, sorry, is our protagonist a woman? We haven't established that.
Oh, you're right. They just had the Metroid twist.
Right. But in reverse.
Right.
Wait, Exhumed, does that have an H?
Three M's.
God.
Snow coffin.
Alf comes back to life, right?
Or does he? Or is it a tourist trap that doesn't work? I'm asking.
Okay, okay. But this is it, Justin. This is where we decide the final fate of this story. Everything hinges on this sentence.
It turned out that was just a door to the gift shop of the place that I'm at in the planet with the stuff in it.
In Space Hill.
We did it.
Oh, man.
Are you okay?
Newbery Award winner.
I think that this one's going to get a lot of teens through a lot of hard stuff. Okay.
Yeah, published now.
Well, do we want to edit the title?
No.
We want it to be called, like, The Worst Vacation Ever? Yeah, actually, you know what? Now yeah, that I, yeah, that's a pretty good title.
Wait, well, okay.
Title.
How about The Worst Vacation Alpha? That's click two with Alf. I want to get the Alf branding in the header.
Yeah, I feel you. How's the SEO? Can we check the SEO on that one?
That's great SEO.
Okay.
That's optimized out the AS.
All right, it's out there. Now we just wait for the commendations to roll in. Oh, wait. Okay. It's publishing to Steam Workshop. You probably can't see that right now. Interesting. Okay, so I guess that's how they...
rope you in.
I guess that's how they propagate that stuff.
So does Gabe Newell own that story now? Is that how that works?
Oh my God, I hope not. Okay, so it's just out there. It has my name on it.
So how do you see other...
Well, we can read... Do you want to read other people's work?
Yeah, if there's one that's not total horseshit. Wait,
here's our published work. So this is how it presents it to you. It takes sort of your words and then it layers it over.
Let's take turns reading. You okay. Do the first section and I'll get you after that.
Sure. Look at this place. It's so horny. And the sand is so desolate, like a dry sandwich without mayonnaise.
The library is full of DVDs of Click, starring Adam Sandler, who's my favorite dramatic actor. I like Click because it shows off Adam's dramatic acting talents. It's all just copies of Click and more copies of Click forever. I think this is where they print the Click DVD.
The sculptures were giant PlayStation Move controllers. This video is brought to you by PlayStation Move. Please, please buy PlayStation Move. We have that game where you're a skeleton guy, so there's that one game. Why did we even make the PlayStation Move? What were we thinking? Christ.
The ruins were in terrible condition, hardly good, and everything leaked a reddish stuff.
God damn, I wish we could have gone back and maybe put a little bit more elbow grease into that one.
That was a pretty good one.
The inspirational posters were so kitschy, and there were hardly enough bathrooms. I looked for a bathroom for a long time, and then I met a beautiful teenage wolfman alien. His name was Gordon Shumway.
What is this, love? Do I love an elf? How is that possible? I am half cat. Whoa.
I'm writing here on this blue wall to note that this looks like a weird orange face, or perhaps half a Pokeball. God, I miss Alf. I miss his smell. I miss his morning time smile. I miss the way his fur would get caught in my mouth from kissing him hard.
There was never any doubt that our parents, who are from space and also a different time, were also Alf's parents. Twist. And the tour guides pointed to the special pit that could bring dead Alf's back to life and said, foreshadowing, dig.
Now, I'm just now thinking this through. Was our protagonist related to Alf? I mean, undoubtedly, they were brother and sister. So maybe that one. We can edit these at any time, but I feel like we already put the English.
It's like Middlesex. It's like Middlesex 2.
Okay. Alf died today. I turned him into a beautiful stoic snowman. I left a hole where I could stuff in cats just in case. I wish there was some way we could be reunited. Do I too must die?
I hurled myself into the Alf pit. The Alf zone, if you will. Don't worry, I had his corpse, which I exhumed from his snow coffin. I waited for Alf to spring back to life, but it turned out the Alf zone was just a door to the gift shop. The gift shop clerk was real cute, though, like super beefy muscles and just tall enough, and his name was Zach. And that's like the sexiest name. We took turns tying each other up with sex rope. We did it all day and then kept reliving that day with a magical remote we got from Christopher Walken at Bed Bath & Beyond. At Bath and Beyond.
Oh, hold on. Oh, shit. I need to get that. Sorry, everybody. We're not going to get the branding. Wait, how do I? Where is it? Come on. Don't make me. There it is.
At Bed Bath and Beyond.
But there we go.
Okay.
Do I have to fly to the end of the level again?
That number in the bottom rants certainly isn't a score in that case.
Oh,
burn.
Publish those changes. Yeah, got to get those back out there.
Got to get that SEO in there.
Okay. And then let's just real quick. Okay, Justin, take it from where you
left. Okay. With the magic remote control that we got from Christopher Walken at Bed Bath & Beyond.
That was him, right? In Click?
Sure.
Have you seen Click? Or was this all a farce?
I didn't watch Click. But oops, I fast-forwarded too much, and I missed my kids growing up. And then on my deathbed, Walken came to me like an angel. He did nothing. He watched as I died. And now Alf and I can be together forever at last in space hell.
Perfect. So you want to read what somebody else, like, sort of their take on it.
Yeah.
Ooh. You want this one, or our future
king? It should let you, like, scroll through first lines, because I think that that's all you really need to.
Maybe there is a way to do that. Well, here we go.
Okay.
The sections just aren't long enough. They didn't spend enough time on them.
Right. I need rich fiction.
Right. So let's just check my commendations. Nothing yet. So when people read your works, they can give you commendations, and then that is the score.
Okay, so zero right now.
Zero right now. I wrote another one the other day. Let's just check on that one. Let's see where we're at. Nothing on that one.
Okay.
This one starts out with the line, "It was the best of times, it was the dirtiest of times."
Pretty good opening line.
Pretty much the best opening line.
You didn't title it. That's your problem.
Well,
who's
no.
gonna read that?
That's a good point. I mean, if that slug doesn't catch him, then what's the point? Anyway, this is Elegy for a Dead World. It's a pretty weird game, but I don't know, man. I'm kind of into the concept. I feel
it feels like,
they
need more people in here doing stuff. How many stories can you read? Like, if you go to Byron right now, like, how many stories are there that you can, like, look through? Are there a lot that you can look through, or how does that work?
Yeah, you can browse. You can look at recently published ones. You can look at popular ones. Let's see what popular ones. Yeah, see, wait, there's a ton. There's a lot.
Oh, great. Okay.
Do you wanna read a good one? Just based on
Yeah, let's see like what an actual
Orange. You glad you're not here?
Are you going to the least popular store?
Yeah. Well, I'm gonna see if ours is. No. Ours hasn't even made. Oh, the Pony World.
Perfect.
Load.
Activate.
Oh God.
They brought things from Earth that.
All right. Where's the ponies? 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 Don't just call your goddamn story the Pony World. Okay. 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 Wait. So the ponies of mass destruction. It should be IES. Can you edit? There should be a meta game where you can edit people's stories if they use, possessive apostrophes accidentally. They destroyed the sun disk. Okay. Oh, this is a My Little Pony thing.
Yeah.
See, I just wanted more of a vanilla horse experience.
So that's Elegy for a Dead World. I think we get it.
Should we write another?
Aren't any points or any levels.
No, but there is, it does teach you how to write grammar better, mm-hmm. and there's some fiction in there.
I guess it does have both points and levels, because there are three levels, obviously.
Mm-hmm. And it has this part, which I really like.
Yeah, I'm really not any more into this than I was earlier.
How many stunt points can I get if I grind the nebula? Whoosh!